All right, ladies and gentlemen, the wedding party is going to join us right now, so let's try to find good pausing points for our dinner conversations, and let's get ready to get excited. Let's first get excited for these two handsome groomsmen and this lovely bridesmaid, Anthony and Phil and Nicole. Let's show some love and excitement right now. Let's put those hands together.
Off of my home, we're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket.
All right, I've got two more handsome groomsmen and another lovely bridesmaid. Put those hands together. Show a little more love for Michael, Cody, and Kaylee. Been so phenomenally, you're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights, when everything goes, nowhere to hide. All right, here comes the groomsman, Ryan, our maid of honor, Brandy, and our best man, Brent. All right, now I want to see everybody up on your feet. Everybody get up out of your chairs right now. Let's get really excited. Let's show a whole lot of love. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jordan and Lauren Nipper. Let's put those hands together one more time for our very beautiful and very handsome wedding party. Outstanding. All right. Lovely bridesmaids, handsome groomsmen, please grab a seat. Our handsome groom is going to share a few words with all these lovely ladies and gentlemen right now.
Hello, everybody. Thank everybody for coming. I'm glad you're all able to be here to celebrate our special day. Hopefully get around and talk to everybody as the night goes on. Feel free to come up to us at the table, anything you want to, and eat a bunch of food. There's going to be a lot of food. And beer. Yes. Yes. All right. Well, that's all I've got. Thank you guys again for coming very much. We really appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, our best man and our maid of honor have prepared a few words to share with us. So let's see if we can find a pausing point for our dinner conversations and focus our attention on this very handsome young man with a microphone right in front of me.
Thank you for that. That means a lot. I'll try to make this short because I can talk forever. We're not sponsored by Budweiser, but that's what I wrote it on. We all know and love Jordan, but he's a weird guy. He does a lot of weird things. You know, if you saw his Steam account, you would know. And if you don't know what a Steam account is, it's nerdy gaming stuff. But that's fine. We need those people. But this nerddom started early on when our grandparents, Paul's here, Grammy, love ya, it would be littered with Legos everywhere. And me and poor Ryan, raise your hand, man. We would be the plebes of this society. And Jordan would sit on his Lego throne and tell us what to do the whole time. What Legos we could use, what Legos we couldn't use. And that's the kind of guy Jordan is, a Lego hoarder. But no, it's funny though, because Jordan is one of the most intelligent people I know. He's smart, he's steadfast, he's a great friend, and me and Ryan both do our own things. I mean, Ryan plays football, you know, I sing and dance, you know. But my whole life, I have looked up to Jordan. And I don't know if I have said that or Ryan has said that, but it's true because Jordan's always been a straight arrow. And he knows what to do. He's level-headed when he needs to be. he knows the path to take. So I've really been blessed being his little brother growing up and being able to have a role model like that. And I don't think he gets the recognition he needs, that he deserves. And then Lauren. You got Lauren. Same thing. You know, level-headed as can be, with a little edge. You know, she's got a bite to her. She's bitten me quite a few times. But it's nice. It's like a dog bite. You know, you let it slide. You're like, oh, I shouldn't have done that. But no, Lauren has been around forever. But it's always been great. I remember sneaking down our stairs when Jordan and Lauren were watching movies. God knows what they were doing. But, and we would be like, girl, and lucky for us, we got a young lady who was awesome. Funny, witty, sarcastic, which I love, and just great. And they've been together a long time now. It's one of those classic, you know, like love stories, you know, high school sweethearts. My Budweiser thing's running out of things to say. But I know that their future together is going to be bright because they're the best kind of people. They're the type of people who do things for others and don't need to tell you that they did things. They just do them. They're the type of people who you know are going to be there for you always. And they're the type of people who, if they do have children one day, Uncle Brent would love that. But either way, they will be amazing, amazing humans for the rest of their lives. And I'm lucky to have Jordan and Lauren part of my family. So to Jordan, you've always been there, so, you know, you're out of the way. But Lauren, welcome to the family. We love you. Thank you.
Hello. Just wanted to make sure it was on. Okay, I'm Brandy. I'm Lauren's sister. And when I found out that I was speaking at the wedding, I knew I had to do something unique because of all the unique moments that they've brought to my life. Just a few moments to cover. Lauren always making pancakes for me when I stay the night with her at her apartment. Jordan and Lauren decorating cookies with us at Christmas and everything turning into zombies. Thanks, Jordan. And last but not least, the best of them all, when Jordan fell flat on his face in our basement and ended up sleeping on the couch in his underwear. And I knew at that moment he was in the family forever. As I said, I had to do something special. So I can't give you much, but I can do this for you. Drop the beat. This is a story all about how Lauren and Jordan fell in love and never fell out. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, tell how it all started and we ended up right here. In a small town called Franklin, they were born and raised. They never knew they would meet back in 7th grade. Moving on to 8th and on the same theme, Miss Cash never knew she was setting up a dream. A couple years passed and he starts to make a move. Jordan tried 3 times till he finally broke through. Lauren thought, why not, I'll give him a shot. Hey, he lives right down the block and maybe I'll get a rock. They dated and dated until they graduated. They packed their stuff and went up on their way. Right state, wrong school or something like that. They thought, hell, we'll stay and might as well kick it. Called the house and thought, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of Ohio State glass. Is this what the life married couple's living like? We might be alright. Whistle for her legs and when she came here, Lauren said don't do that and Jordan didn't care. Anything you can tell, this house is ran. Lauren says go, you know Jordan's right there. I'll do it. Now we're at this reception, all celebrating the match made in heaven. Single life, see you later. Take a look right here, put your glass in the air. Let's all sing a toast for the couple of the year. I cried.
Aww. All right. And with that, it's time for our lovely bride and our handsome groom to come out and have their first dance as husband and wife. Mr. and Mrs. Jordan and Lauren Nipper. This will be our last dance, so if you have not worn out your dancing shoes yet, this will be your last chance.
Go home. but you can't stay here. I know who want to take me home. I know who want to take me home. I know who want to take me home. Take me for you to go out to the places you will be from. Closing time. This room won't be open till your brothers or your sisters come. So gather up your jackets, move it to the exits. I hope you have found a friend. Closing time. Every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. Yeah. I know who I want to take me home. I know who I want to take me home. I know who I want to take me home. Take me home.
Right now, one more time for Mr. and Mrs. Jordan and Lauren Nipper. Put those hands together right now.